Hi there, I'm Scott Lowe with ActualTech Media. I'm here today with Emilio Billi, who is the CTO of A3Cube. Emilio, thank you for being here today.
Thank you to you.
So let's talk about some of the technical items that we have in the A3Cube architecture.
Yes. So if you look at this picture, you see the modern, we can say, data chain. So we start from a storing information, and we need to produce some result to act. To act means to take decision, to make action, or for example, for a self-driving machine to drive by itself. So if you can see that if you cannot consider anymore a store information out of the cycle of the computation, because if you have to extract useful information from the data, you have to do in an infinite loop. So continue to querying the information, extract the information that you need from all the thousand and thousand data that you can have in your repository, and then uses this information to extract statistic information that made use, that create useful value to have the reaction on that information. All this cycle can be done thousand and thousand and thousand times over the same data or new data. And the time between the storing of the information and having the time to react can be very, very short. Imagine a self-driving machine. You cannot wait 10 minutes to decide if you have to turn or not. You cannot. You have to do it in real time. And if you have to train some algorithm, you cannot take 6 months to train one algorithm and discover after 6 months that this algorithm was not good. So you have to do it in the shorter time as possible. So the storage is not anymore a passive element into the computation. 10 years ago, you can start from here and having the storage infrastructure, and then you have the computing infrastructure. The time to access to the information was not so important. The important things was how fast you can perform the computation. Today, no. Today, high-performance computing is became high-performance data. Everything is data-driven. And the time, so the latency between all the operation is became the key factor on all the computing, emerging computing systems.
So what actually is the product? Is it a hardware play? Is it a software play?
Well, it's a suite, so it's a software suite that actually optimizes and uses in the best way the hardware resources. So it's a combination of both, we can say. So we don't produce hardware, we produce the software infrastructure. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, the software infrastructure is taking the maximum advantages from the acceleration that today is built in the modern hardware. For example, the modern interconnection, like Mellanox RDMA-based product, have inside accelerators that offload the CPU from many, many computing tasks related to the network. Okay, we have a connector that can take the maximum advantages from this new technology. Today you have accelerator like GPUs. For example, it's impossible to think about to train a machine learning problem without having a GPU. The reason, because one problem, for example, training 1.4 million of images with a single CPU, so you can take 53 days, something like
that.
Yes. With 8 GPU, you take 23 hours. So 53 days, 23 hours is better, 23 hours. So it's impossible to think to make new computation without accelerator. So what we done is also to integrate into the storage chain these emerging technology like accelerator, because as the CPU, the accelerator need to access to the data. And the best is to do directly.
So from where is the A3Cube solution pulling the data? We know that it's not just a bucket anymore, but is the data still on an array that you're bringing into memory, or is it on a PCIe card? Where does the actual storage live?
Well, we create a way to aggregate different type of storage device, normally the cutting edge, so SSD, NVMe, and the tiering in a multiple level, automatic tiering across the entire system. So we will have automatically data that can be stored in SSD, then can be stored in NVMe for warm data, up to the DRAM for the hot data. And this triple tiering not only is done inside the, what we say, the storage machine, but across the entire cluster.
So this is a cluster of nodes.
Nodes.
And the storage is local to those nodes to reduce the latency. So it's not, you're not pulling from external storage anywhere.
No.
But it's a combination of SSDs, NVMe, and RAM. So
absolutely.
You're tiering
inside the node.
Is it tiering in real? Is it tiering automated in real time?
Yes, absolutely. In real time, on basis on the loading of the data. We can also leverage the external storage by connecting directly with emerging technology like NVMe over fabric.
Right.
So you can have external storage connected to the local node. The local node performs the tiering between the NVMe over fabric through the RDMA, because the key is to use the RDMA low latency, and the local memory. So in any case, we are able to scale to very large number of petabyte and petabyte of storage by maintaining the lowest latency across all the nodes connected together.
What kind of latency do you see in a well-designed, in a ideal use case for this technology?
Okay. Fantastic. The lowest is the best.
Yeah.
So we know that the access to the memory is in the order of nanoseconds. The access to the NVMe is the order of microseconds. And the latency to the old type of storage is the order of milliseconds. So we try to keep the latency in the order of microseconds across the entire chain. So we means that our interconnection fabric is use only RDMA, so we can stay in a latency between 1 to 3 microseconds. We use tiering between NVMe and DRAM to maintain the access to the data, in the worst case, in order of 10, 12 microseconds, and the best case, in order of 2, 3 microseconds.
Got it. So if I'm buying the solution for a high-performance computing cluster, what do I need in my servers? I know I'm just saying I'm going to need the H3Cube software, but what do I need in my servers to make it all work, other than storage?
Okay. Actually, you need, of course, memory.
Yep.
128 gigabytes is the minimum to have this tiering efficiently, but better is to have more memory. And you need our computing suite software that is run on top of standard operating system based on Linux. So nothing exotic.
And the interconnects are done over RDMA using the PCIe bus on each individual server?
You can use any RDMA-capable fabric.
Okay.
The best is used to Mellanox ConnectX, because we optimize with Mellanox this kind of operation. You can use also PC Express fabrics, not only from H3Cube, but also for third-party vendors. And you can use, if you want, also Rocky, so RDMA over converged Ethernet. This is the last chance to have the best performance.
Got it. That's probably is that the lower performance option because of Ethernet, the non-deterministic stuff?
Exactly. It's the lowest, but with the use, intensive use of Rocky, so RDMA over converged Ether, we can, in any case, have a better performance than any other existing equivalent solution.
Excellent. Emilio, thank you for this technical overview of H3Cube.
Thanks.